welcome to Knoxbox. I am Knock himself. With me tonight is Cordial Rob.
Good evening.
And Miguel.
Boon-y-boo.
You'll never get past it. We do apologise.
So, welcome back to the tale of four incompetence, which has grown somewhat. We've had a few of you out there on YouTube contact us and want to join in.
And some of our locals.
And some of our locals.
Have taken some interest. Yeah. Exhibit.
Hey, Miguel.
Can't prove anything.
Apart from the starter box in front of you.
So it's now a tale of some incompetence. At least four of them will be in each filming. So we are all at different stages of our army. Miguel has worked out an army list and has the army box and the codex. Wave them, Miguel. Wave them like your life depended on it. Yeah! Rob has got his army box, put them all together and started painting them. I have spent today cracking through painting, and I have finished two of my units, with two more to go. And Spencer has
not even
arrived to pick up his box. So,
however, I know how we can cure that.
Oh, we could summon him in, then he could see it.
And then we can heckle him.
Yes, and he can see it
however,
for the first time.
The cone hasn't arrived yet.
Yes.
Although, so there is still time for Spencer not to wear the cone.
Yes. Probably. So, let's summon Spencer.
One, two, three.
Spencer Pants! Spencer! You've
done your hair again.
You've joined us.
Yeah.
Spencer, everyone. Spencer Pants. So, Spencer, you have not bothered coming to the shop yet to pick up your Necrons, even though it's been with us for about 4 days.
I'm really terrible at this sort of thing. I give you my sincerest apologies.
Thank you very much, Spencer. I appreciate that. So, Spencer, talk us through what you're doing with the Necrons.
Yeah.
Please don't hit us with the box. They are pretty.
What do you like best about them, Spencer?
Green.
That's a good one. Green. They're green.
Would you like to look inside of the sprues?
Yes, please.
Go for it. It's your box, Spencer. You help yourself.
Thank you.
I have the feeling that we're going to regret this at some point, probably in the future.
They will.
So, Spencer, what do you think?
They look rather cool. It's going to involve an awful lot of work, though, which I may not have time for around my working hours, which I'm currently busy at right now. I mean,
oh, yes.
I'm here.
Yes, you're here.
I'm
you're
here.
Not at work. You're here, yes.
Things to make note of is the green bits. You stick them in after you've painted everything
yes,
else.
I know you, and you do not want to spray with these bits in because it'll just wreck them.
Spencer, you know more of Warhammer than we thought.
Well,
this is impressive.
Spencer knows Necrons,
so
missiles.
So, Spencer, so everyone out there is aware, Spencer, what are you going to have done by next week?
Before
how
the cone
much
arrives.
Will you have done?
I, Spencer Pants, are going to have these all glued, painted, and ready.
In a week's time, Spencer?
Oh, yes.
Have you got enough
Spencer
time?
Spencer is going to do this.
Late-nighters,
wow.
Late-nighters, here they come.
You heard it here first. Spencer has agreed. So, that well done, Spencer.
You can do it.
I'm manning up.
So, you have you worked out your army list yet? No, just no, okay.
No.
Well, let's run through the ones that have worked it out. I am doing Blood Angels, and I am going with a real death or glory theme. So I have really set this up, so everything in my army that could take either a flamer or plasma has gone for that. Because my idea is with plasma, when I overwatch the people that will surely be charging me with Chaos and Nurgle and stuff, I will either kill myself on a 1 or you on a 6, and that seems fun. So I've got death, so I have 2 5-man tactical squads, both with a captain with the freebie chainsword and
sergeant.
Then sergeant, sorry, with chainswords and then plasma pistols. Each one of 5 also has a specialist weapon choice, is the plasma gun. So 4 plasma things to begin with. I'm pleased with that. I would have given my captain plasma, but he comes with no choices, monoposed and fixed in. And the idea was we have to take what's in the starter set. So I have taken it. I haven't changed it at all. So I have my captain, who hasn't got a name yet. I'm thinking Glory Hole. No, that's a tank. He'll have a name that something to do with either death or glory and also a little smutty. So I finished painting him today, and painting red on red is boring. But
and
it's
then
okay.
He got to ink them with more red.
We will do a close-up later on so you can see how bad our painting is. Yeah. We have tried and we can attest that these are to our ability. We're not skimping out, but we're just not that good at painters.
don't know, finding times.
You are very good, you. Medallions.
Thank you very much, Spencer. It's nice to have you building me up. I wish my wife was as pleasant as you are. So, I also have taken...
So much trouble.
So, this commander comes at 145 points. The tactical squads are 100 points each with the options. And then I have a Baal Predator. So, the Baal Predator is the Glory Hole. And it is moving, as always. It has a Flamestorm Cannon on the top, because I wanted to go with the theme of the army.
Torrent.
And then two Heavy Flamer sponsors, so all of the flame. A Dozer Blade, which doesn't come in the kit.
Which is quite annoying.
And GW don't sell as a kit, but Forge World do. So I have two on my way from Forge World, one for this and one for presumably I'll need another at some point.
Why do I feel I'm going to get tank shocked by this at some point?
Probably.
Screaming burn, heretic burn.
It will have a Dozer Blade that will be painted up and glued on afterwards. It has extra armour and a Storm Bolter, so it's fully WYSIWYG. And at the back, I have, the front, I have a little picture that has death on it, and on the back, a little picture with glory on it, which is also on the hole to enter the tank, which amuses me.
No end.
It does. So I come in at exactly 500 points, and I'm happy with that and feel somewhat proud of myself for making 500 exactly.
Without a melter bomb here or there.
Oh, we haven't gone for competitive armies. Yeah. So anyone that in the comments says, but you should have taken, I've intentionally gone for thematic and fun to play.
So he'll be usually killing more of his marines than I will with his plasma.
It's going to be great.
Last but not least, we'll ignore you for the minute.
Last.
Aww.
Okay. So you're like the penultimate, but after the last.
Oh.
I'd just sit on the floor, shall I?
Well, you are a demon player. And it's not even the right sort of demon.
So, talk us through yours, Rob.
Okay, I have got Skitarii. These are a bit of an odd one.
Oh yes, your commander that you can't take.
I have a HQ choice for another army.
Yeah,
which is the Ad Mech army, because they didn't stick them all in one book.
Yeah, the Get Started Skitarii box has an Ad Mech commander in it, which you cannot use in the Skitarii army without taking, you know, like
an ally detachment.
But you haven't got enough in the starter to take the
attachment. But I have got enough, so... That is two troop choices and a heavy support, because there's no HQ choice in this Skitarii Codex, so your minimum is two troops choices, which is basically 2 5-man squads. So I have enough for a legal tournament army. Ooh, hoorah.
Are they all WYSIWYG?
They are WYSIWYG, so I have the Plasma Culvern, the Trans something
Arbor. It looks like a Skaven Giselle, but nice and sleek.
There are Giselles laid from the army. I have a Arc Pistol and Taser Goad.
The Taser Goad looks actually amazing. I need that as an orc weapon for my Grot Herder.
He probably does. Mm. And then I have a Doomcrawler Onager with a Neutron Blaster, a Cognis Stubber, a additional Cognis Stubber, a upgrade that gives it will not die and it can repair itself.
How many things are on the front of that? You got electro probe thing as well.
It has got more probes than the dark.
I think that's part of that thing.
Is that part of that thing?
That's part of that thing.
It's a device from Star Wars.
It does actually.
It's amazing.
There are some influences we can see here.
We will give you close-ups of this.
Yeah.
It's not finished painting. Oh, is that finished?
No.
That's not to your ability, is
no.
it?
No.
Rob has painted blue and silver so far. It does look good though.
It does.
I'm doing. Whether it's going to bite me back on the bum or not, I'm doing Night Lord colours.
Blue to black with lightning bolts.
Yeah, and Nuln Oil everywhere.
Yes. Do you know how many points yours comes in at?
Just under 500.
Just under 500.
Because I took all the expensive upgrades.
Absolutely. So, and then, actually I'll cover that afterwards. Do you want to talk us through what you've got so far? So you've got your box and your book.
Yes, I've had a brief look through the book.
About half an hour.
Yeah. And, well, I've got something that I think will work.
Okay.
As an army. So I've got my Herald of Khorne on his Blood Throne with an exalted reward, because I thought the bigger the better for Khorne.
Roll all the dice for the snazzy things.
We've got the group of 10 blood letters that's in there. One of them will be a Blood Reaper.
Extra attack.
Yeah.
Why
attack.
Not? One of them will have the Banner of Blood.
Yes, absolutely.
Better charge?
Yeah,
like
instead of
6 plus d6.
Once per turn, 6 plus d6.
So you guarantee 7.
Yeah, absolutely.
And they have the great reward.
Cool. And an instrument, if I remember correctly.
Yes, and an instrument. Because that helps with the warp.
Yes, the instrument lets you re-roll the corn warp. When you roll on the warp storm table.
There's a cornate one.
There's a cornate one that hurts other people's units, and that helps you re-roll that.
Yes. And finally, I've got the blood crushers. Again, one of those will be a blood hunter, because why not? They also have an icon, but not the Banner of Blood.
Yes, we think it's one per arm with Banner of Blood. We'll check that.
And they have greater rewards as well.
But they don't have the instrument because it looks silly.
So I'm going to go ahead and guess what your scheme and your plan for this is. Roll on as many tables as possible.
Yes. And shout warg.
So every turn you have the Warp Storm table, and in every game you've got three different rewards you have to roll for at the start of the game?
Yes.
At least you didn't take the three minor rewards all in one thing.
I really hope you didn't have a wrist injury.
No, Miguel is so well practiced at that. So, going on to carrying on, we've had a think about the rules for this. And so, obviously, Spenty Pants' army will be a legal army, I believe, when it's all put together.
And
I think he has two troops.
Nope.
Scouts count as troop choices.
Do they?
I believe so. So I think he has two.
Oh, cool.
He has a legal army. I have a legal HQ, two troops, something else. You have a legal army because your book has no HQ in it, and that's all you have to take.
Yep.
You only have one troops choice.
Yes, because there are only 10 blood letters in the box, and that's the minimum for their squad.
So, month two, the first thing we have to do is make sure our army is legal after that. So you will have to get a troops choice.
Yes.
After that, it will be another 250 points to spend. Rather than a box, we looked at it. And if we go from 500 to 750 points, it'll be another 250 points to spend however you want, as long as your army remains legal.
So you're going for a Land Raider?
No, Dreadnoughts, all the Dreadnoughts.
Oh, really? Because Furiosa and Dreadnoughts aren't...
I didn't say Furiosa, I want Plasma. I'm going to see. But also, some of the other rules... If we have a squad in our army, it is always in our army. You can change the upgrades on them as long as they remain WYSIWYG, but you cannot remove a squad from the army. Okay? So you can't say, actually, I don't want that to get the points back. But you can change over the upgrades.
Yeah. Otherwise, things get awkward with that HQ I get in my starter box.
For yours, because you began with that HQ in your starter box, I've spoken to everybody else playing, and we have agreed that you are allowed to, at any time you want, when you've got the points to do it, put an allied detachment of Admech in.
Okay.
Because you have that in your starter box, so we don't.
Yeah.
You can't use other demons, you are just Khorne.
Yeah.
I can't use other Space Marines, I'm Blood Angels, Necrons are
don't
Necrons.
Have friends.
They don't have any friends, yeah. Don't worry, Spencer,
but it's fine. Historically, you're allowed to bro fist with the Blood Angels.
Bro fist. Both has to be so hard. Sorry, I've spent time with Dan, good friend Dan, today, and I'm just full of smut because of it, and I'm sorry.
You're only blaming him because he's not here.
It's the best way to blame anyone and they're not here.
That is. Anyway, so what are you looking to purchase for your...
Oh, no, don't even ask me that, I've got no idea. I haven't even started playing with the army yet, I've got to learn the rules, work out what's fun, and then I'm just going to take more of what's fun. Oh, no, I lie. I know one thing I'll buy.
You're taking Dreadnoughts! You've already told me you are taking Dreadnoughts!
First off, I'm going to upgrade my 2 5-man squads probably to 10-man squads, because then I have heavy plasma cannons. So I'm going to have a heavy plasma cannon, a plasma gun, and a plasma pistol in each squad. And that'll just be fun. Ones or sixes. This will be so good. But, so yeah, you've got a rough idea of what we're going to do. We really are incompetent. We are just getting to grips with this. We've managed to get hold of some of the books and... I've watched a couple of battle reports online to see roughly what Blood Angel's meant to do.
Run forward screaming blood for the Emperor.
And I've decided not to do that. I'm going to just go with fun, and fun for me is as many explosions.
If I remember correctly, you said you're going to have the least amount of models at the end.
Yes, that is my goal.
I'm going to try and beat him.
I don't think you can with it.
I'm going to take all of the big things.
So, 3 Bloodthirsters, right?
That's how he rolls.
Yeah.
And a sea of...
Oh, that case, Spencer.
In that case, I'll probably end up with a sea of Skitarii then.
Yes. And Admech, they've got some cool big stuff. Spencer, what do you think you could take next for yours? Specifically name them, if you could.
More warriors. They're your troops' choice.
I can't just have like two Triarch Stalkers then?
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, you can, yeah.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Although, to be fair, you really want to go for the barges, the little flying barges that either have the massive big Gauss gun or...
Those are the ones that look Cylon ships, aren't they?
No, those are the Croissants. No, you can have those. Doomsides are something you can take, Spencer.
That's quite cool.
So are you saying now, Spencer...
Giant floating pyramid of doom.
Yeah, the monolith.
The monolith. Just one monolith.
And it just teleports and lands on other people's units. If it's good fun.
You had to pick one that you as Spencer are guaranteeing you're putting in next month. What would that be?
Necron pylon.
As Spencer, I would guarantee that it would be some warriors. Spencer,
you're being nice to yourself.
Very sensible.
Yeah, that's what I do.
Anyway, we're rambling. We will give you some close-up filming shots. Believe us, they're not amazing. But you can see roughly where we are at the moment.
Need more time. Until next time. We'll be right back.